Hi, I'm Satvi. Welcome to my channel Let's Design Engineer. Here I'm gonna give you the brief introduction of my channel. In this channel, I'm gonna upload tutorial videos of all the mechanical design softwares such as CATIA, PROE, SOLIDWORKS, ANSYS, UNIGRAPHICS, AutoCAD, etc. In this channel, I'm gonna give you everything from head to tail of every software with detailed explanation. So that's it guys, let's start the introduction. Before going to the design softwares, let us see the definition of the design. Here you go. Design is a specification of objects intended to accomplish the goals or strategic approach for someone to achieve an unique expectations. I think there is not much needed to explain the definition of the design. And here, there are a lot of definitions, but the core point doesn't change. Am I right? Okay then, let's go to the design softwares, which are categorized into three segments. So I'll let you know that. First one CAD, second CAM, third CAE. CAD computer aided design, CAM computer aided manufacturing, CAE computer aided engineering or analysis. So I'll list out the softwares which will come under these three categories. First one, computer aided design. Here we have AutoCAD. This is a 2D software. I mean we can draw a 3D also, but this AutoCAD software will be used for 2D especially. And SolidWorks, PROE, CATIA, SolidWorks, UNIGRAPHICS and etc. These are the main softwares which will be used in industries, and this will be useful for your career. And in this channel I'm going to discuss this segment. And next thing, CAM, computer aided manufacturing. You know, the manufacturing is done with the help of the computer. So these are the softwares MasterCAM, DelCAM and CNC. And to know the softwares, I mean to operate the softwares, you should know the codes, G codes and M codes. These G codes and M codes will play the main role in the softwares. So if you know the codes and how the coordinates, X, Y axis, where the tool should be moved, and how the workpiece should be placed in the fixture, and you'll be learning everything in this CAM. And this will come under ANSYS, LS-DYNA, Nastron, HyperMesh. These softwares will come under this computer aided engineering or analysis. Let us consider a product, for example a bottle. So the bottle should come to the market such that the customer required the bottle which should be more sustainable, and it should not be damaged if there is any impact load on it. So okay, I'll design in this software, and can I manufacture it directly? No, you should not manufacture it. First of all, you should analyze it, whether the bottle is sustainable or not, whether the bottle matches the customer's requirement or not. So first we should have to analyze the design and analyze the structure by adding the loads on it, and we should take the results from it. So by studying the results, we should change the design, or we can change the material, so to reach the certain specification of customer. That's it. And next thing, and these are the brief introduction regarding CAM and CAE. So let us go to the CAD, CAD, computer aided design. So there are mainly four modules in the basic modules in every software. So I'll explain you one by one. First one, Sketcher. In Sketcher we'll be drawing a 2D sketch which will be having only two dimensions. And second thing, part module. In part module we'll be drawing a 3D models, we'll be having X, Y and Z direction. So in 3D models, so we can draw any part module. For example, let us take a pen, let us divide the pen into three parts. First of all a cap, and second one a body, and third one a refill. Okay, so all the three parts in part modules separately. And afterwards, what should I do? I should assemble the three parts to one. Am I right? So we'll be having another module called assembly. In this assembly module, we'll be adding these three part modules. We'll be assembling these three part modules to become a complete model. am I right? That's it. So I'll be explain. So you'll get little bit confused if I explain everything about regarding every module. Okay. Next thing is a drafting. Drafting is nothing but after completing the model, so we'll generate the views. You know the views, right? Top view, front view, side view, and all. And there are the four different projections: first angle projection, second angle, third angle, and fourth angle projection. Depends on the projection, the views will be generated according to the according to your selection. That's it. Because for example, if you take a CAD here and if you select the first angle projection, so it will generate the views according to the first angle projection and vice versa. Okay. And after projecting the views, we will specify the dimensions of the complete body, and if there are any additions to the model, so you can directly change in the part module. Automatically the adapting views will be changed. So I'll just let you know what is the difference between and all. So in parametric softwares only we can see these changes. And next thing, I'm going to tell you the difference between the parametric and non-parametric softwares. See, here you go. In parametric softwares, we'll be having ProE, CATIA, Unigraphics, SolidWorks, and all solid modeling softwares. In non-parametric softwares, we'll be having AutoCAD. In this, the default plane is front plane. In this, the default plane is top plane. And the orientation, trimetric view. Trimetric view will be the orientation of these softwares. And you know what is the trimetric views? 60. The body will be represented in such a way that all the three planes will be 60 degrees with respect to the body. And isometric, you already know that. I mean, 30, 120, 30 degrees. And in parametric, icon based, non parametric, command based. Icon based. For example, if you guys all know that how to operate paint, right? So here there will be having a line, circle, color, and all. So there we are not typing any command in that. We are just selecting the icon and we are just placing it where we want to draw. Am I right? So in parametric it is icon based. It's not a command based. In non-parametric it's command based. Command based is nothing but, for example, if you want to draw any lines and all in AutoCAD, so first of all you should know the command how to draw. Am I right? For example, I want to draw a line and I should type a command called L and enter. So the line command will be activated. So after that itself only you can draw the line. So you will be get to knowing in the further videos. So these are the basic parametric and non-parametric differences. There are so many differences, and up to now I am just constraining these differences into a little lesser. So while in the videos I will be explaining what is a parametric and non-parametric and all. Okay then guys, thank you. Let's meet in the next video. See you guys, take care.